I don't think it was the intentions to go to one bank and say we need to borrow $50 million whenever we was discussing these projects and doing local. I think the discussion came about at some of the public meetings that we'd talk to four or five banks and we'd have one lead bank out of those banks to they pool their money, and we'd give all the interest back locally to the banks here, which we think would be a lot cheaper than going with bonds. So as a recommending body, I'd be opposed to going with bonds because I think you'd spend a lot more money, plus it'd take a lot longer. And let's keep the money local with the local banks. I didn't have any authority, but over the period of the last 12 months, I've talked with several different banks, and that's what they would like to do. The investors would like to pool the bank's money and loan the county whatever money they need toward this. That was discussion that I had with some of them, and I think some of the board might be privy to that. But so that was discussion that went on during the SPLOST referendum.
I will need to talk to them about how we're going to fund that.
One last thing about timing for bond issues. As far as when do we need to know as far as which way the path goes, probably need about 2 to 3 months to get to go to market with a bond issue. That's how much time we need as far as working with the underwriters. Now, we're going through a refunding issue right now, so I don't know what's involved in doing that. So 2 to 3 months, we can probably do it in 2 months, but that just means if we think those interest rates, municipal bonds are going to be more favorable than if the primary groups or banks are not just offering us a low enough rate, if we think bonds are a better option. We need to make that decision when we're within about 2 to 3 months of needing some cash flow surplus. So that's our, and we're not there yet, so I think that we're consensus that okay. Fork in the path, if you will.
There have been some discussion about banks, and I need to make a disclosure that I'm the vice chairman of the board of the Citizens Bank of Forsyth County, and if that bank is included in any of these discussions, I would have to disqualify myself from any voting or consideration, because that would be a conflict of interest.
Mm-hmm. Thank
so
you, sir.
I want to make that formal disclosure.
I'd like to make a disclosure too that my wife serves on the board with Jeff, Captain Amos, so I would also too. If their name came up, I would have to recuse myself from any discussion with their vote.
Okay. So noted. So without exception, is that the direction the committee wants to go, is to have today run some numbers and bring it back next meeting?
Yeah, have some discussion with some banks.
Yeah, if anyone's familiar with any local banks you think are interested, please let me know. We'll talk to all of them. And I think that there's been interest from what I'm going to say about working with local financing. We've never really defined that at this point. I think I recommend those that have a presence in the county one way or another, and some are larger institutions, some are, but they need to be large enough to handle this kind of transaction as well. Sometimes there's a consortium of banks that work together. So have some kind of presence in the county, or if it's been a bond underwriter we've worked with before, that would at least narrow who we work with down to those. But otherwise, we're already getting people from outside the area contacting us about they want to do bond issues and other things. So.
Would it be then the desire of this committee to identify what this committee believes and then make that recommendation board what a local bank is, or leave that to the board of commissioners once we get to that point?
Certainly, if their headquarters here in the Baster, that'd be more roots of being local than just having a branch or two here.
Well, we don't have a lot of them as headquartered here. We have the smaller banks as headquartered here in Cumming. We don't have a lot of them that is the big banks, but the four or five that I've talked to are the smaller banks who wanted to come together as a group and have one lead bank and all of them pool their money, and that one big lead bank to be the one that would deal with you on your draws. So if you wanted $50 million, $25 million, or whatever, they could come up with that as a pool.
Yeah, as long as the numbers work, I agree with that. If you want to keep your money local, then you can. So.
We can furnish some names to you, Dave.
So no action from this committee with respect to what a local bank is?
I don't think we need to go there.
Okay.
Fact of the matter is we don't have but a two or three little small local banks. I think we just need to give them names. You know, we know the banks here in the area, and we want to be sure the banks are coming for South County Bank at the operation here.
For clarification, not just a branch, but the
right.
The main offices here.
The main offices here?
Yeah.
Okay. then this committee's desire to just have Mr. Gruen talk to those banks?
I couldn't give you the name of all the banks that would be there, so I don't know which banks they are.
Okay.
Why don't we consider this? Mr. Gruen will get with all the banks that are local, have their main headquarters here, and see if they can pull it together. If they can't, then he'll secondly have to go look at the next level of tier out, when they have a lot of branches here, employees here,
they have presence here,
and also look into your bonding sources that we've used in the past.
Gotcha.
I guess that takes the question that we've had. Once again, I agree with concept. How do we define a local bank?
I think because we're the branch, we have headquarters that can be here.
We got some that, not that I know, I would presume that maybe we have some that have quite a lot of branches here, do business here, but their main office might be in the just across the county line in another county. But yet they are not one of the big, national banks that just have branches here. So we're back to trying to establish what's the criteria to define.
I guess we're talking about local banks. We're talking about banks that are located here in the area where they, where the headquarters out of Charlotte. Where they say headquarters out of Florida.
Would you prefer the headquarters are in Georgia first, if that's at all possible, to keep some of the main funds local?
That might be a more. That may be one way to start drawing it down. They're headquartered in Georgia. Yeah. They're chartered in Georgia, I guess.
That would help a lot, probably.
With branches here.
With branches here.
Mm-hmm. Without exception?
Abstain. And by the way, Mr. Chairman, I've got a jury waiting on me.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Judge.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Okay.
I think we have a strong committee here, and I'm looking forward to getting this project started as soon as possible. Make tremendous value to our county and city.
How are you?